Hey everybody, it's Lex from Admin Arsenal. Let's talk about Microsoft DFS, and specifically in regards to replicating the folder where we keep the install files for PDQ Deploy. Where this comes into play is if, let's say, you have a main branch and a remote branch, and you want to be able to deploy to the remote branch without having to have the remote branch have all the install files copied across a wide area network. So what we end up doing is we replicate those, and then we have PDQ deploy call the namespace or the DFS replicated folder at the local site. So let me take you through how we do this. So first things, set up the lab. You'll notice I've got this machine we're looking at right now. It's my main server, which will be my main branch. It's got a gray background. And then I've got site one, which is my remote site. It's got the blue background. So first thing we're going to do is we're going to go and set up a shared folder. So on my C drive, I'm going to go make a folder called installs. And then I'm going to go share this folder. Now, the thing about sharing your folders, obviously, with PDQ Deploy is you need to make sure you've got permissions set up on that folder to allow the credentials you've set up in PDQ Deploy to read and write to it. So I'm going to add domain admins right now. Okay, and make sure it's got read-write access to it. Hit OK. And then that folder's ready to go here on the main. And then I'm going to bounce over to my Site 1 machine and do the same thing. I'm going to go build a folder. And I'm going to call it installs because it's going to be a replication from installs on my main machine. And again, I'm going to go share this. And then I'm going to go set permissions on it again, read write for the credentials I use. Okay, so that shared folder set up, ready to go there. I'm going to bounce back over to the main machine and we're going to go add some roles. So we're going to go add, obviously, adding roles from the server manager window or server manager. Click next, we're going to add file services. Okay. A couple of next through that, you'll notice here we now have the distributed file system. Now on your main machine, okay, you're going to want to add namespaces and DFS replication. It'll be a little bit different on your remote site, but I'll show you that in just a sec. So we're going to set this up here. Now the namespace is what you're going to use in your UNC pass so that you can actually call the replicated folders. So since we're going to be using deploy with this, I'm just going to call our namespace deploy. Okay, so you can see the namespace preview. It's going to be the name of my domain because it's a domain based in deploy. I'll show you this more in a minute. Okay, need to have an account that allow this to be built. Okay. There we go, there's our deploy. Okay. Server might need to be restarted after the installation completes, something to note. We hit install, it's going to install file services and DFS. So once that's done and we've confirmed that that's installed here, I'm going to bounce back over. We'll go over and set up the remote site. And then once we get the remote site set up, we'll configure the replication. So this usually goes pretty quick. It's configuring. There it is. Installation was successful. We're done here. Now, over to the remote site. Now, file services is installed already here. So I'm going to go, I'm going to right click on that, and I'm going to add role services. Okay. With this, once we add role services, I'm just going to add replication here. Okay, I only need to add the replication because we're going to be replicating that folder. It does, namespace is already set up for us on the main. So this install again is just setting that up. Now, once that's done, again, I'm going to bounce back over to the main and we'll finish the replication. All right, successfully installed. So back over on our main machine now, I'm just going to minimize this. We're going to go in and we're going to look under administrative tools. We now have DFS management. Okay, if we open this up and we take a look at our namespaces, you'll see we've got Deadwood Local Deploy, it's our namespace, and under replication, we are going to add a new replication group. We are going to delete an old replication group. And we're going to go add a new replication group. Okay, it's a multi-purpose replication group. Okay, the name of it, we're just going to call it installs. Okay, now we got to go add our servers. Okay, we need to add our main server, which comes in pretty quick. And then we're going to add site one. Okay, this is going to take a minute. It's going to go verify that the appropriate things have been installed, and then it will add it as a member of this replication group. Now, once that's done, both of these will show up under members. There it is. We'll go to the next step. We're going to have a full mesh, so it's going to replicate both directions. Okay, we're going to use as much bandwidth as we can, just use full bandwidth. And then the primary member of this is going to be our main server here. Okay. At this point, we need to add the path. What are we going to replicate? So we're going to replicate the installs folder here on our main machine. There it is. We give it an OK. It's shown there. Now, site one. It knows it needs to be set up, so we're just going to go edit the path. Okay, we're going to enable it, and then we're going to pick installs on site one. We hit OK. Give it a next. Lists all the information in regards to what we're going to do, and we're going to create the replication group. Now the replication group's built. Okay. All right. Our replicated folder is installs. It's not published, but let's go and take a look at our installs folder. There's installs. I'm going to go and let's put a new text document in there to see if it's actually replicating across. So this one's coming from main. I'm just going to call it main test. Okay. Now it's going to replicate. It's going to take a little bit of time to do that because it's not instantaneous at this point because it hasn't picked up. We'll go over and we'll pull up the file folder on site one. Oh, check it out. It actually did replicate. So now you can see we're replicating back and forth between the two. Okay, so you can see they're replicating back and forth. Now, the other thing I'm going to want to do is be able to call it from a namespace, right? So deadwood.local/deploy was the namespace we set up. Now you notice it's not showing anything there, and that's because I published that folder. So if I go back here to installs, all right, click on share and publish the namespace. Okay. I'm going to take the main site because that's where I'm at. I'm going to browse, and there it is. Our namespace is deploy. Give it an OK. The new folder is going to be installs. I click next. It's going to create publish share. And now when I go back here, you'll see installs and main test. So again, path on that, Deadwood local deploy installs. Pulls it up there. Now if I bounce over to the other site and I do the same thing here, Deadwood.local deploy, you also see installs there. Again, we're looking at the same thing. So from both sites, I can see that exact same UNC, except this one's looking at the local copy. So that's setting up DFS in a nutshell. I'm going to do another video here, which will show you, you know, how to set up and point your repository at this namespace, and then how to copy your current install files and packages up to that. Thanks for watching, guys. I'm Lex from Admin Arsenal. We'll catch you all later.